गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज मिस्टर राव। वायरसेस कॉजेस वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ डिसीजेस इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी एंड दिस डिसीजेस हियर शोज देयर इन्फ्लुएंस और देयर इफेक्ट ऑन द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। सो कमिंग टू द टाइप्स ऑफ द डिसीजेस कॉज्ड बाय दिस वायरस, हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस और वन थिंग इज द कॉमन कोल्ड, वी कॉल इट एज हियर रेनाइटिस इज वन ऑफ द डिसीज कॉज्ड बाय ए वायरस। Whereas the second type of disease that we are going to see is poliomyelitis. The poliomyelitis generally is known as infantile paralysis. And the third disease that we are going to study here is rabies, and this is otherwise known as hydrophobia. And the another disease caused by the virus, it includes the chikungunya, and thereafter the another one is the dengue. The dengue is otherwise known as breakbone fever, and thereafter the another one is viral hepatitis. These are all the various types of viral diseases that we are going to see in detail in the coming session. Right, let us see each one in a detailed way. Coming to then another important disease that is caused by the virus is known as the rabies. Might be heard about this one. The rabies is particularly here known as hydrophobia. You know, the phobia means fearing of something. Here hydro, it represents the water. The person who is suffering from the rabies, he do here fear of the water. That is the reason why in general the rabies is known as hydrophobia. And constitutive organism for this is rabies virus that causes this disease here, rabies. And generally, how does it get transmitted? When you see the mode of transmission, if any animal here which is suffering from this rabies, particularly here the dogs, jackals, as well as here wolves and the cats, these are all the types of the animals. If the time these animals are rabid in the sense the mad, and when do they get the madness? Generally because of this virus, because this virus even it attack on the central nervous system. So because of that reason, these animals become here rabid. When such a kind of animals here it bites any other human being, then the viruses get transmitted. So this is actually the major mode of transmission, by the bite of rabid. It means a mad. Here animals like dogs, jackals, wolves, as well as the cats. If any person bitten by these here animals, then the virus it get transmitted. This is actually the mode of transmission. Then once when you hear bitten by this animal, if really the animal is suffering from the rabies, then how much time does it take for the manifestation? And here interesting thing is the rabies incubation period, it ranges from 10 days to almost all 1 year span of time. So after the bite, here the person may develop the disease within the 10 days, or it may take 1 year for development of the disease. So this is actually the incubation period. Once they complete the incubation period, what are the symptomatic characteristic features that developed by a infected person? The first thing you can see here, the fear of water. In the beginning of that part itself I said, here the person, he will be fear of the water is one of the characteristic feature. And thereafter you can see the saliva, it comes out of its mouth. Saliva comes out of the mouth of the infected person. Thereafter, lymphadenopathy is one more important characteristic feature. And here, and along with that, you can see the severe headache. Thereafter, the high fever. And next one, here it destroys the brain and as well as here spinal cord is one thing. And destroys the brain as well as spinal cord are all the symptoms of this disease. I repeat once again, fear of the water, saliva from the mouth, thereafter severe headache and high fever, and destroys the particularly the nervous system like a brain as well as the spinal cord. All these are the symptoms will be get developed by the here person suffering from this rabies. And when you see the rabies, one it is developed in the human being, there is no other way, it is 100% fatal. 100% fatal in the sense the person will die definitely when he get or develop the rabies. So the rabies is 100% fatal disease, so dangerous disease. and thereafter when you see the rabies and the prevention and treatment for this, what is the prevention and the treatment, sir? Then prevention method for this rabies. So once here the person is get bitten by a infected any animal that I mentioned above, here there are certain kind of prevention methods are there. The first and important thing here, immunization to the dogs as well as here the cats. So the generally we do have the habit of here rearing the pet dogs and cats. So those who are the dogs having the owners, and the owners should go for immunization of their pet dogs and cats, so that they will be protected from this virus, and even if that is bitten any other person, then he will be protected from that. And the second important point is destroying of here ownerless dogs as well as the stray dogs. And some of the dogs, they do not have any owner. They used to here wander here and there in the streets. Such a kind of stray dogs as well as the ownerless dogs must be get destroyed is one important thing. And another important here one is, once if any animal here bitten, immediately the person should wash the wound with a soap, so that here the some extent the bacteria can be eliminated, can be here removed from the infected part, is one more important thing. If any person is bitten by here any other animal, unfortunately he must go for taking the anti-rabies vaccination. So by taking this anti-rabies vaccination here, some extent here we can prevent this one without developing in our body. So this is actually the prevention method of the rabies. So let us switch over to the another here important viral disease that generally occurs in us, and it is very frequently happening nowadays. So we will see here, that is about chikungunya. So such a kind of disease is also caused by the virus. See this one, chikungunya is a viral disease, and the chikungunya is caused by here a virus which is known as the chikungunya virus. And the mode of transmission here, it includes here there is a vector for this transmission of a disease, and this vector, it includes Aedes aegypti is the name of the mosquito. And this Aedes aegypti, if it bites and here any infected person, then the virus is get transmitted to this here mosquito. Thereafter, if the same one is get bite any other healthy person, then the virus is get transmitted to him. So this is actually the mode of transmission. Aedes aegypti, it's a kind of your mosquito. It's a mode of transmission. Then here, what will be the incubation period for this? If you see, it takes near about 3 to 6 days span of time for its incubation. See this, for manifestation or appearance of the disease, the total time taken by these here the virus is 6 days or 3 to 6 days span of time. Then here, what will be the symptoms of a disease? Coming to here, the sudden onset of a fever, and next one here, crippling joint pains. The person will experience the severe joint pains, and there you can see here, lymphadenopathy is one thing. The size of your lymph nodes will be greatly get increases. So that condition is known as lymphadenopathy is one thing. Thereafter, conjunctivitis is one more thing. Generally, you might have suffered from this one. Conjunctivitis is nothing but here the eye infection, and that is caused by the virus. The conjunctivity is one more here symptoms. These are all the major symptoms of the disease when you are suffering from. So one is the sudden onset of fever, crippling severe joint pains, lymphadenopathy, as well as here conjunctivitis. And whereas when you see, what will be the here treatment or prevention for this available to us? Once you see here, elimination of the mosquitoes. I said, since the mosquitoes are the causative organism for transmission of a disease from infected person to the healthy person, so if you can destroy these vectors and if you eliminate the here the population of the mosquitoes, there is no transmission of the disease from person to person. You know, the various types of here methods are available to us in order to here reduce the mosquito population. Generally in our day-to-day life, we are all using here mosquito repellents like All Out's, Good Nights, and here the paste that are all available to us. In order to that, you have to make sure that water should not be accumulate or logged in or around our house, because the stagnant water is the breeding place of a mosquitoes. So that is the reason why you have to make sure that there should not be any accumulation of water in or around your house is one another important thing. Thereafter, releasing the fishes like gambusia. If you release that one, the gambusia fishes actually feed on the larva of a mosquito, so that they will be get destroyed. Even the eggs of the mosquito also taken up by this gambusia type of fishes. And thereafter, sprinkling or spraying the oils like kerosene oil and all on the stagnant water, so that it leads to here destroy the larval stages of the mosquitoes. And growing the insectivorous plants nearby the accumulated water. So these insectivorous plants naturally feed on the insects. So by all these methods, generally we can here reduce or eliminate the mosquito population as well as their eggs. And one more important thing, you have to take some symptomatic here treatment. So I said certain kind of here symptoms will be developed. So in order to suppress such a kind of symptoms, we can take a various types of here the drugs. First thing is a fever. In order to treat the fever, you can go for taking here paracetamol tablet is one thing. Then you do explain here, you do experience the great pain also. In order to relieve from the pain, you do take here different types of analgesics. Here is one thing. So analgesics are pain relieving drugs. We will study more detailedly about all these things in the upcoming lessons. And next to this, you can here explain the joint pains, and here joint pains can be here get relieved by taking of aspirin, a kind of a drug medicine. So with by taking all these things, generally we can prevent the disease. So this is, and when you see here, the best method for relieving from the symptoms and here get recover from these, taking the adequate bed rest as well as taking the sufficient amount of liquid diet. When you take these two things, actually that protects us, or that here helps us to recover from this disease. So this is all about here the disease, that is chikungunya. Then another viral disease, and which is the last one under this heading, the viral diseases, is nothing but the dengue fever. Then dengue fever in general used to call it as here break bone fever. And this dengue is caused by here flaviriboviruses. So is the name of a pathogen that causes, or the virus that causes this disease. And here the transmission, mode of transmission. Just now I explained how the chikungunya is get transmitted. In the same way, Aedes aegypti is the name of a mosquito which get transmits this virus from infected person to the healthy person. So this virus, it act like a vector. And next, coming to this incubation period, once the virus it enter in the body for manifestation, it takes place a 3 to 8 days span of time. And once the incubation is get done or completed, then it develops some here the symptoms. And the symptoms it includes, and it causes two variety types of here the symptoms or diseases, which one we call it as classic dengue fever. This is an important part. Then here in the severe condition, we can happen to see dengue hemorrhagic fever also. Now I do explain in detail the both types of fevers that caused by this dengue. So under normal condition, what will be the symptoms developed, and that is known as a classic dengue fever. So when the condition is severe, which takes away the life of a person, then what kind of develop here symptoms will be developed, we will see now. Coming to the classic dengue fever, it includes a sudden onset of fever will be here noticed. A sudden onset of fever is one of the characteristic feature. And that followed by here severe frontal headache. This is the area at which the victim experienced the great pain. Only in this area frontal headache is very common. And coming to the third symptom, he will experience the severe pain behind the eyes, and that makes the worsen the movement of the eyes also is one more important thing. So behind the eyes, particularly the here the pain will be a great pain will be experienced, and which makes here his eye movement very poor. Eye movement of the person is becomes very poor because of the great pain behind his eyes is one more symptom. Next one is muscle as well as a joint pains. Here throughout the body we can see the muscle pain as well as the joint pains also. And meanwhile, you can see here loss of appetite. That means the person or the victim will not experience any hungry. And you can see the development of rashes on his body also is one more thing. The rashes on his body. And next to that, you can see the nausea as well as the vomiting. Nausea in the sense, a kind of vomiting sensation, giddiness, and it followed by even vomiting sensations. So vomitings also it takes place. All these are the variety of symptoms that are all here comes under the classic dengue fever. And in some cases, when the condition becomes here deteriorated, then it develops into a hemorrhagic here dengue fever. In that condition, which kind of here the symptoms will be developed, let us see now here in a detailed way. So in the dengue itself, when the condition is too severe and the person will develop another here fever, that we call it as a dengue hemorrhagic fever. Hemorrhage in the sense breaking of your blood vessels, and it leads to here bleeding of the blood also. So that we call it as here dengue hemorrhagic fever. Under this disease, actually he develops a certain kind of disease symptoms. We will see now the symptoms here in a detailed way. So bleeding, it takes place from his nose and gums of a mouth. And here even the skin also, skin bruising. Bruising of the skin, it means it develops some here wounds is one thing. So this is one of the important characteristic feature of the hemorrhagic fever. Bleeding from the nose, mouth, gums, and the skin here bruising is one important thing. And next to it, you can see here a severe and continuous stomach pain. So very severe, and that leads to a continuous stomach pain will be get experienced. And that followed by here the frequent vomitings. Sometimes the vomit will be including the blood also. You see this one, continuous, very frequent vomiting will be taken place with or without the blood is an important thing. And next to this, you can see the pale, cold, clammy skin. Skin becomes pale in the color, and if you see the cold temperature on the skin will be get reduced. And the clammy skin here in the sense, that means damp and sticky. Damp and sticky skin here he will have. And next to that, you can see the mouth becomes dry. Dry mouth is one more characteristic feature. And next to that, rapid as well as a weak pulse. Your pulse will be here very rapid, but the pulse is very weak is another characteristic feature. Difficulty in the breathing will be experienced by the victim. And next to that, restlessness and here constant crying. The person doesn't have any kind of here rest, and he will go on crying because of these great symptoms. So all these are the symptoms of, this is a point, dengue hemorrhagic fever. In this condition, there are chances for death, and these chances are more. It is more fatal here disease for a humankind. Then what is the prevention for this? As I said, in case of chikungunya, elimination of mosquitoes as well as their eggs. I said the various methods of elimination of these mosquitoes and their eggs. In the forthcoming part, I will explain in detail about the things. And next to that, here you can go with a here certain kind of even the drugs also. And here the thing that you need to do, the person should be taken the bed rest is one thing, and adequate fluids must be taken so that relieves him from the pain and all, and he may be get cured whenever they follow the things. And here making use of analgesics is one thing. Analgesic is nothing but a painkiller. I said here a severe body pains are here experienced by the person, even the stomach ache also. That is the reason why you need to take this analgesic drugs so that you will be get relieved. Here the very important the point that to be noted, the person suffering from this dengue should not be taken place two important drugs. And these drugs it includes, one is the desperin as well as aspirin. These two drugs must not be taken by the person who is suffering from this dengue. It causes some side effects and it makes the condition so here worst, and so that it leads to death of the person. And this is the point to be noted in case of dengue. So these are all the varieties of the diseases caused by the virus in the humankind, and the symptoms respect to here the pathogens and the symptoms caused by these diseases in the human beings, and what are the prevention and treatment for all these diseases also we detailedly happen to see. So in the coming session I will explain about some more diseases caused by the fungi as well as the protozoan, and finally we do shift over to diseases that are all caused by some other pathogens like helminthic parasites and all. So thank you all.